OperaWine, OperaWine, OperaWine!
Nobody who knows anything about Italian wine can ignore the importance of Sassicaia. The first vintage was in 1968, I think.
68 was the first commercial vintage, but the wine was... We said to make the wine 20 years before. 48 was the first vintage. But for the first 20 years, it was only for family consumption, local consumption. And we started to sell the wine in 68.
And this was the first, really one of the first shots in the Italian wine revolution.
Yes, exactly, because nobody was using production, the yield per hectare was cut down from what was the normal production in Tuscany, and we introduced the cabernet sauvignon instead of Sangiovese, and I think the cabernet sauvignon adapted itself very well in our climate, in our terroir.
And in those days, the Sangiovese was not very good, was it?
No, Sangiovese in that area was not very good, and Sangiovese is anyways a difficult grape, depending on weather. If it starts to rain in September, you can lose the whole crop. And Cabernet has a thicker skin.
Can I taste? This is the 2009 I think we have here. Can I taste it?
Yes, of course.
This was a good vintage for you.
Yes, I think vintage a little more extraction. Previous, 2007, 2008. I think with 2008, one of the best vintages of the decade.
Lovely. I mean, the interesting thing is this is Bordeaux varieties, but it doesn't taste like Bordeaux. There is a very... I've been asking other people, where does this Italian character come from? Is it soil or is it climate?
The soil is what the French call terroir. I think we have a very special terroir, a very special climate, and we have been lucky to find a grape variety which adapts itself very well with that type of terroir.
To me, it has the blackcurrant character, the cassis character of the Cabernet Sauvignon, but it's much more savoury, it's more olive, and more.
Soft tannins. We have always been looking for elegance more than big extraction. I think wine is something that we enjoy working with. We shouldn't be too
But also, to me, what I find is a very fresh acidity, which is what makes it a very drinkable wine.
Yes, drinkable and long aging. I think Sassicaia has a very good longevity. The wine keeps improving with age, and I think you are always surprised when you open a bottle that you forgot in your cellar.
Well, this wine is still a baby, so I think it needs at least 5 years, maybe 10 years, before we really open it again.
Yes, I think you are right. But it's still. I think softer than some Bordeaux when it's young, but as you say, it needs 10 years to reach its
Thank you very much.
OperaWine, OperaWine, OperaWine!